Hey, Spencer here, and today I'm going to show you how to connect a Blu-ray player to your TV. It's really simple. As long as you know all the connections and what you're looking at, it's going to be super easy. Let's first start by looking at the rear panel of the Blu-ray player and just getting a grasp on all the inputs and outputs on there. So if you've got a much newer Blu-ray player, it's probably only going to feature an HDMI output and the internet connection or Ethernet cable output. The HDMI output is going to be your audio and video connection. HDMI is going to be your best option no matter what is on here. It's going to provide the highest resolution and the best audio quality. And then the next step down regarding video would be component video. As you can see, that's just a video output, and to the right of that is your analog audio output. You would connect that for audio. And then you've also got some other connections. You've got S video, which is one step below component. And then you've got composite, which is the lowest quality video. Then you've also got optical and coaxial digital audio. Those are going to be for connecting it to a sound system. And then on the back of the TV, everything pretty much looks the same. The only difference that you'll notice is instead of the connections being labeled out, they're labeled in, which means that the signal is sending into the TV. So if you see anything labeled out, you're not going to want to use those. Those are going to send a signal out of the TV, generally to a sound system. So we've got HDMI, which is going to be your best option. All you need is one wire for that from the Blu-ray player to the TV. And then of course you've got component video right next to the analog audio, composite video, and this TV does not offer S video, so we won't be able to use that. Let's also talk about the audio video cables real briefly. So we've got composite cables, which is red, white, and yellow. And then we've got the HDMI cable, which is just one cable for audio and video. And then we've got the component video cable, which oftentimes it will come with just the video and the audio will be separate. So this is red, green, and blue, and that is just video. And then this big one right here is red, green, blue, and white, and red. That features the audio and the video all in one cable. It is kind of cumbersome to have two completely separate cables. This one has just one. So let's go ahead and connect it to the TV just so you see how to set it up. We're gonna use the HDMI cable for this. So just plug one end of it into the back of the Blu-ray player and the other end into the TV. Once you have it all plugged in, make sure you set the input on the TV to the correct one, which is going to be HDMI 1. And then now you can see it is playing just fine on the TV and it's all completely set up. At this point, you may find out that you need a remote control for it because a lot of Blu-ray players do need remotes to go through the home menu. If you're looking for the remote or any of these cables, you can definitely get them from us. We've also got Blu-ray players available. Make sure you check them out. You can go to our website at SpenCertified.com and you can call to order or order online. And if you appreciated this video and if it helped you, please leave a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.